In the still Lister Hill Library. Some consider it a barren wasteland, never daring to set foot within its walls. Some may pass through on occasion to pass an hour or so before class starts. To others, it may be a way to get some free tea on Wednesdays about 12:30. But to a few, a very select few, mind you, this place is home. Which brings us to one particular Lister dweller, Mr. Zack Rolen, a second-year dental student.
It hasn't really been that long since the first time that he...
Shh! Let's start at the beginning. The search for your spot is always a significant one in every student's life. Some may never find it, being forced to take on a nomadic way of academics, traveling from place to place in search of the ultimate study utopia. For some, though, the quest is an easy one. No one witnessed the actual moment that Zack found his study spot, but it's rumored that there has never been a more sublime connection between man and chair. In the still of the night. Over the next few months, willpower met its first challenge. There's nothing like a fundamentals course to break you into a library. Meals were infrequent. Exercise was but a past memory. The local Chevron saw an unexplained 15% increase in energy drink sales. Yes, Zack began to suspect that he may have underestimated the length of his stay at Lister Hill, but his only choice was to push forward. The spring of 2012 became a dark time for dental students, Zack in particular. The library staff really started to take notice of this late night dweller.
All right, man. We'll see you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Meals, well, they lost their luster. Zack's knowledge of current events became limited to the weather and time. The local Chevron was happy to see yet another increase in energy drink sales. These were troubling times, and no one made that more apparent than the nail clipper of March 2012. It started like any other second floor study session. I'd like to tell you that things got better, but fate had a different plan for Zack Rolen. Bizarre strangers seemed to come from all over campus just to see what was happening on second floor.
Out, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up the way. Are you ready? Roll it. 1.
Zack seemed to be the constant that they needed in their study lives.
Other way.
One particular occasion confused Zack. On Monday, a boy sat beside him with a cough that sounded an awful lot like tuberculosis. So Zack moved. Tuesday came and he found Zack again. And this continued for an entire week until finally on Friday, Zack reached his lowest point to date. But then it got better. People didn't seem to bother Zack as much anymore. His study habits became more efficient. Having enough energy was no longer a problem. Zack even found a little extra time in his schedule for things like politics, culture, and, of course, sports. By November of his second year, Zack might as well have owned the place. He knew that there were approximately 104 chairs on the second floor, and that the left side of the library was approximately 3 degrees cooler than the right. He could probably tell you what door was being opened just by the pitch of the squeal.
Men's bathroom, second floor.
Hey, Zack, do you know where the principles of pharmacology book would be?
Well, about Procter or Gamble?
Gamble.
What edition?
The third.
All right, QV700.
Thanks.
He knew that if you wanted a drink of cool water, the shorter fountain was your best bet.
Rookie.
Yes, Zack had done just about everything there was to do here at Lister. There was only one thing that was missing off his list.
Yeah, I need to check out a book.
Alrighty. Zack Rolen, let's look you up here. Wow, dude, you mean to tell me you come here every night and you've never checked out a book with us? Dude!
Some said it would never come. It's the night before the last systems exam. No one asks where he is, because they already know. 500 days finally comes to an end. Tomorrow, Zack will be free.
Alright, man. See you tomorrow.
Not this time.
Rumor has it that he still visits old Lister on occasion, whether it be out of necessity or just to maintain his presence. So if you ever find yourself in Lister Hill Library late at night, find comfort in the fact that you are not alone. He is there, somewhere. In the still of